Good evening, dear ladies. Let's bless that we will all have the school to greet Mashiach Tzidkan Bacham Limuim Bimra Biamenu Amen. Eliyahu Navi, Eliyahu Tishbi, Eliyahu Agiladi, Bimra Yavelan Mashiach David, Eliyahu Navi Zachul Atom. And we all have the school to see the building of Beit HaMikdash HaShlishi Bimra Biamenu Amen. Ki Ayin Bainiru Bishuvad Mai Tzion. Natata Kum Terachem Tzion, Ki Et Lecha Nena Ki Ba Moed. Hashivenu Adonai Elecha Venashub HaChadesh Emenu Kekedem. And may we all have the zchut to go to Eretz Yisrael on the wings of eagle, and may we all have part in Eretz Yisrael. B'shem Hashem na'aseh v'netzliach, en od milvado. Hashem shpatai tiftach ufi agin tiratecha. And everything that we're doing is b'shem kol Yisrael. Everything is leilu nishmat. All of the souls that were murdered viciously by the terrorists and all of our soldiers. That Hashem aleihem shalom tivishlam tzora betzor chayim Hashem yikom damam Hashem will revenge their blood and b'siyata dishma it's also lilu nishmat all of the souls that don't have anybody else to say kaddish for them when they have the yortzeit so b'ezrat Hashem that they will be zocher with us with everything that we do and it's also lilu nishmat Eliyahu ben Yosef b'malkadina alav shalom tivishlam tzora betzor chayim and Yaakov ben David ושרה זוהרה עליו השלום תהי נשמתו צרורה בצרור החיים ומשה בן David ושרה זוהרה עליו השלום תהי נשמתו צרורה בצרור החיים furthermore it's לרפואה שלמה for everyone health mentally and physically בעזרת השם and it's also health mentally and physically to all of our soldiers and all of the captured may Hashem bring all of the captured immediately home healthy mentally and physically Be'ezrat Hashem and among all of the sick people Ochana ben Olga Miriam bat Shena Chana Eliezer Chaim ben Raya Moshe Erez ben Esther Shirel bat Isabel Esther Isabel Esther bat Ilana Kosover Rebbe הרב שרגה פייבוש בן מלכה, גבריאל בן זילפה, יוסף בן שרה, אסתר בת שרה, מזל בת רחל, יונה בת שרה זוהרה, דבורה בת שרנה, בלה בת עדינה אנג'לה, אנג'לה עדינה בת גולצ'רה, מזל טוב בת שמחה, תקווה בת הורי, זליה בת פרידה, חווה בת חנה, שרה בת מלכה, שרה בת מלכה, שרה רחל בת חסידה, שרה, לאה פרלה בת חנה ברכה, אביגייל בת אסתר ברכה, שרה בת אסתר נחמה, איילת בת גאולה, איילת חיה בת גאולה, גיטל בת חווה, ראובן בן זינה, אלור מיכאל בן שירן, הלני אורנה בת חן חנה, ארי שמעון בן מיטל מזל, אברהם בן רחל, התינוקת שרה, התינוק משה, can you please mute yourself? בראל בן הילה, ירון בן יצחק ויבלנקה, משה אהרון בן רייזל, אלתר פרל בן גיטל, נונו רחל בת תמר, ג'נט שושנה חיה בת אולגה חיה, and בעזרת השם את עיר הסורים, I'm very sorry, מחילה, I send you today because I saw it all over that that they already released Ervin Avner Netanel Ben Siona Sonia but it's not I understood it's not true so from there on I'm afraid to put anything just let's continue davening for him from Etir Asurim that he will be saved you know the young boy the bachur 20 years old from Iran Ervin Avner Netanel Ben Ben Siona Sonia that he will be מתיר אסורים, רוזט ורד בת עודת יהודית, שושנה בת אסתר, יעקב בן מלכה, מתיר אסורים, and all of the captured, בעזרת השם, מתיר אסורים, that everybody will come home
safely. I think there is מתיר אסורים. I got the text, I posted it, he was saved.
No, but they say it's fake news. I got, I put it on the WhatsApp, and then yes, they told me it's not true. I don't know what's going on here. But בעזרת השם, let's continue davening for him. אז השם יודע מה לעשות. And בעזרת השם, that man, השם stand on the right side of our soldiers, ויתרם בחתר השואה, ותרת ניצחון, וילכו לשלום, ויחזרו לשלום, ויוצאו את כל החטופים בריאים, ובעזרת השם, יוריד את ראש הנחש. אמן כן יהי רצון.
אמן כן
יהי
רצון.
Now, dear ladies, we are going to speak about Parashat HaShavua. This is Parashat Shlach Lecha. It's the portion, this Shabbat is the portion of the Meraglim. It's also Shabbat Mevarchim, Rosh Chodesh Tammuz. The Rosh Chodesh is next week, Shabbat and Sunday. Not this Shabbat, of course. The next week, the end of the week, Shabbat and Sunday. It's 2 days of Rosh Chodesh. We'll speak about it next week, Bezrat Hashem. But this is Shabbat Mevarchim, so I'm reminding you, please read the whole book of Tehillim. It's a big zchut, especially on Shabbat Mevarchim, Shabbat that we bless the coming month. Bezrat Hashem, if you go to shul and you divided at shul, tavo lechem habracha. If you can't go to shul and b'siyata dishmaya, do it at home, like we do it on the WhatsApp, divide it by you or join us on the WhatsApp for reading that book of Tehillim and Chumash Devarim. You can choose a portion and a mitzvah that we all do together. It's like each and every individual is doing it on himself. So you're at home, but still you are joining in that group all the others that are reading, and by this it's like you finish the whole book of Tehillim on your own. So b'siyata dishmaya, we're going to start. We know that the Meraglim, Moshe Rabbeinu chose, Hashem told him to pick up all of the Meraglim, all of the spies that he sent to see the land of Canaan, and it says like this: "Vayedaber Hashem el Moshe lemor, shlach lecha anashim vayetur et eretz Canaan asher ani noten libnei Yisrael." So Hashem tells him, he speaks to Moshe Rabbeinu and he says, "Send forth men if you please, it's for you," because Hashem gave a promise that he's giving us the land of milk and honey, the land of Israel, which was called the land of Canaan. And we see over here that he tells him, send, and that they should be the head of the tribes. And it says, Al pi Hashem kulam anashim veishlach otam Moshe. Moshe is sending them mimidbar Paran, from the wilderness of Paran. Al pi Hashem, by the word of Hashem, kulam anashim rashei bnei Yisrael hema. They are all the heads of the children of Israel, which means they are all big scholars in Torah. They are the presidents of the children of Israel, of the tribes, and they are going to Eretz Canaan, to the land of Canaan, and coming back in order to bring a report. And over there they see that the people in the land of Canaan are burying the dead. It says, the Mefarshim says, Hashem made a plague in order that they won't notice the 12 men that are coming in. And some of the Mefarshim say this was Iyov. Iyov passed away exactly at that time in order that the spies that went into the land of Canaan won't be noticed. And they see the fruits. The fruits are gigantic. They have to carry, a few people have to carry them together. Even one grape. So we see over here that they see that everything is... there's also giants. They see the giants, and they see the big walls that are in, that are protecting the places. And they come back to the children of Israel after 40 days. Rashi says they started the trip at the 29th of the month of Sivan. They came back on the 9th of Av, exactly 40 days. And when they come back, וישובו מטור הארץ מקץ 40 יום. So after they were in the land of Canaan for 40 days, they came back. והלכו ויבואו אל משה ואל אהרון ואל כל עדת בני ישראל. So now they are going to Moshe and Aaron and all of the children of Israel, which means all of the assembly of the children of Israel. And instead of speaking privately to Moshe Rabbeinu, which is the king of the children of Israel, and Aaron, which is the high priest, they speak in a loud voice, declaring everything in front of all of the assembly of the children of Israel. And they slander the land of Israel. They say, yes, it's a land of milk and honey, but there's a problem, there's giants over there, and we are in our eyes like grasshoppers if we compare ourselves to them, and this is how they see us. and they say they have big walls, and it's and the Amalek is at the south of the land of Canaan, and it's impossible to conquer the land. This is very interesting. God that showed the children of Israel the 10 plagues in the land of Egypt, God that opened the ocean to 12 paths and all of the waters around the world, this is the same God, the Hashem. Hashem hu Elokim. Hashem is God. And he tells the children of Israel that this is the promised land that he promised Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, Abraham, Yitzchak, and Yaakov. And he tells them, don't worry, I'm going to give you this land. And human beings that are the head of the children of Israel come and they give a report that we cannot go into the land because there's giants over there and we can't conquer it and cause all of the children of Israel to get into panic and anxiety. And the children of Israel stand and go out of their tents and start crying, why did you take us from Egypt? It's better that we were in Egypt, because now we're going to die in the desert. Unbelievable. How can this come true? How can this be? Because God is promising the land of Israel to the children of Israel. How come the 12, all the 12 spies that came in, 10 of them are, 10 of them are slandering the land of Israel? But, girls, can you please mute yourselves? Okay, but this is not only their sin. It's not only the sin of slandering the land of Israel. Look at what punishment they got. The punishment is immediately them, all of the 10, their tongue was made longer and was connected to their belly button, and the worms came out of the tongue, went into the belly buttons, and killed all of them in a plague. This is not a natural death. In order that everybody will see that this is the word of God. This is the word of Hashem. And it's a big question. Two of the spies did not join him, with Yoshua bin Nun and Caleb ben Yefuneh. Yoshua bin Nun from the tribe of Ephraim and Caleb ben Yefuneh from the tribe of Judea. They are the only ones that will go to the land of Israel or have part in the land of Israel. Caleb ben Yefuneh will have also the part of Hebron. And we see that they are trying to speak to the spies, the other 10 spies, that they won't slander, and they're trying to tell the children of Israel, don't worry, Hashem promised us, he will do it for us, we shouldn't be afraid of anything, it's the word of Hashem. But it's more than this. And because of this, Hashem said, because you cried, the children of Israel were crying without any cause, because God promised the land to the children of Israel, to Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. And because they cried, and this was the ninth of Av, Hashem said that this will be a day of crying for all of the generations until Mashiach comes here. This is Tisha B'Av. This is the ninth of Av. When we go into the month of Tammuz, we have on the 17th of the month of Tammuz, the walls of the city of Jerusalem were ruined. On the 9th of Av, all of the temple was burnt. The children of Israel were sent to exile. And we see it until today. And every time on this time, these 3 weeks, and especially the 9th of Av, unpleasant things Lo Aleinu happen, God forbid, happen to the children of Israel. So we are, again, the question is, how did they do this? How do they come to such a thing to cause the children of Israel such a damage for generations? And what was their sin? It wasn't only the slandering. I'm going now to Od Yosef Chai, to Ben Ish Chai, and he says this. והנה ידוע, עניין המרגלים לא היה רק אבו נוגע בכבוד הארץ. So the spies' sin was not only that they slandered the land of Israel, שהוציאו עליה דיבה, ארץ אוכלת יושביה היא, אלא אבון היה חמור מאוד, But the sin was that they did was severe, very severe. שהוא הכחשה בנבואת משה רבנו עליו השלום. They didn't come to the head of the children of Israel at that time, which was Moshe Rabbeinu, and his brother Aaron HaKohen, the high priest, Aaron the high priest. They didn't come to them. They spoke in front of all of the assembly of the children of Israel. Can you imagine? To everyone, they should have came privately to Moshe Rabbeinu and spoke with him about everything that they saw. But instead of that, they came and they did it publicly in front of everyone. Why? Because they had their own personal interest in this. And it says, Eliyav on chamur mod, shu hakhasha benevuat Moshe Rabbeinu. When they said that we cannot go into the land of Israel, it means that they are denying the prophecy of Moshe Rabbeinu, of the king of the children of Israel, that his prophecy is from Hashem, from God. שנתנבא ואמר להם בדבר השם יתברך שיביאום אל ארץ טובה ויתן אותה בידם בנחת ושלווה ותיפול אימתם על יושביה. That all of the people of the land of Canaan will be afraid of the children of Israel, because this is what God said. והם הכחישו בכל זאת, בכל זה שאמר להם בשם השם יתברך. And they denied everything that Moshe Rabbeinu told them in the name of God. ואמרו שהוא מעצמו דיבר כל זה. And by saying to the children of Israel, giving a report to the children of Israel that they can't conquer the land of Israel. You know, history just repeats itself. Because we can see now what's going on in the land of Israel, that there are some that speak and make the children of Israel weak. We just need אין לנו על מי להישען אלא על אבינו שבשמיים. We should always lean on God, and God, the God of the Israelites, which is the God of the whole world, the God of all humanity, the God of all creation. He's the creator. And when we lean on God and have faith in God, He will help us. Nobody can stand in front of us. והוא מעצמו דיבר, והשם לא ציווה. So they referred like Moshe Rabbeinu did not hear really a prophecy from Hashem, but him from himself said the prophecy. And why? Because they had personal נגיעות אישיות. They had personal personal agenda, because they knew that when they come to the land of Israel, now in the desert Hashem provides food, they are the head of the children of Israel, they study Torah, they don't need to work, but when they come to the land of Israel, then they start working the fields, they will have to work, then they won't be heads anymore. These were very righteous people. It's the evil inclination that caused them to fall with pride. And by this, they had their own personal agenda, and by this, they caused all of the children of Israel to fall. And look, history is repeating itself. So, it's written over here that they said that Hashem did not really command Moshe Rabbeinu on his own. He thought about this, and he just told him this. למה השם מביא אותנו לארץ הזאת לנפול בחרב? So why does Hashem bring us to the ארץ כנען in order that he will kill us by sword? ניתנה ראש ונשו במצרים. So it says, let's go back to Egypt. Can you imagine? שבזה כי חשו גם יציאת מצרים, and by this they denied that Hashem made for them miracles to go out of Egypt. לומר משה רבינו עליו השלום הוציאם והשם יתברך לא ציווה חס ושלום. That משה רבינו took them out and that God didn't give him this decree. וכיוון שעשו הכחשה בנבואת משה רבינו עליו השלום, and because they denied the prophecy of משה רבינו, which means they rebelled against the leader of the children of Israel, which is the connection between God and the children of Israel. הנה בזה הרסו כל התורה כולה. By this, it's like they ruined the whole Torah. What does it mean they ruined the whole Torah? The purpose of all of the of creating the whole world is Bereshit Bara Elokim. It says in the beginning Hashem created. And the beginning refers to the children of Israel and the Torah, because Torah is from divine wisdom of Hashem. And in the beginning, beginning refers to the children of Israel and the Torah. It's called Reshit Darko, Reshit Darko. And Reshit Darko is the Torah, and it's from Mishlei, Reshit Darko Mishlei, chapter 8, verse 22. And Reshit Vuata, Reshit Darko means in English, the beginning of his way, of the way of Hashem, and which is the Torah. And the children of Israel is called Reshit Vuata. Yirmiyahu the prophet says, chapter 2, verse 3. Reshit Vuata, the beginning of the harvest, is the children of Israel. Why did Hashem create the world? Atza lasot lo dira batachtonim. Hashem wanted to do well in this world. The Shekhinah, the divine presence, is all over the world. But when the children of Israel received the Torah and the Holy Tent, the Holy Tent was built, then the Divine Presence dwelled mainly in this world, in all worlds, but mainly over here. That's what Hashem wants, that we will make ourselves, each one of us, as individuals, a vessel for Hashem's light, for God's internal light. Hashem is good, God is good, and the essence of good is spreading good. He's dwelling all of His goodness over all of the world, all humanity, all the creatures, all of the world. The only creature in this world that has freedom of choice is us human beings. We are the only creature in this world. The creation of Hashem, humanity, we have a freedom of choice. So when they went, and why did Hashem create the world? Because He wanted the children of Israel to study Torah, and by this, when there's awakening in this world, there's awakening in heaven, and it's like a cycle. And Hashem dwells all of its blessings, abundance of blessings to this world, by the children of Israel that are studying the Torah. When the spies came and they denied and they rebelled against the leader of the children of Israel, the king of the Israelites, which was Moshe Rabbeinu, that he was the connection, because we asked him to be the connection, the middleman. You remember the children of Israel received in Parashat Yitro, Chumash Shmot, the Torah, and when we were around the mountain of Sinai after the two commandments, Anochi Hashem Elokecha, I am Hashem your God, Lo Yelech Elokim Achirim, you won't have other gods. After these two commandments, each commandment that was heard from the mouth of Hashem, it's the word of Hashem, then the souls of the children of Israel went out of their body, and Hashem brought a dew of resurrection and put it on them, and again the soul went into the body. After the second commandment that it happened, they asked Moshe Rabbeinu, we all asked Moshe Rabbeinu, that he will be the middleman, because otherwise, if it will be the third time, we'll become angels. And Moshe Rabbeinu was heard all of the commandments from Hashem, and he passed it through to the children of Israel. Which means Moshe Rabbeinu is not making up anything. Everything that is said is by the word of Hashem. When he appointed Aaron to be the high priest, it's because Hashem told him to appoint him. It's not because he chose it. Everything that he did the word of Hashem. And by doing this, which means they are denying not only Moshe Rabbeinu, also the whole Torah. Od Yosef Chai, Rabbeinu, Ben Ish Chaim continues and he says, "Ve'bazeh perashti b'siyata nishmaetam mismichut parashat ha-meraglim v'parashat Korach." And that's why we see parashat Korach immediately after. "Mipnei ki shnei inyanim elu hem shavim b'ra'atam." Because Korach did the same thing. Once he denied that Moshe Rabbeinu heard everything, what he tells the children of Israel is from Hashem, then by this he's denying also the Torah. So both of them did the same thing. And what happened? how do we know? But look how beautiful he says. עוד יוסף חי says a beautiful thing about זה. וכמו בסוף דבר נעשה תועלת לחזק נבואת משה רבינו עליו השלום. But eventually, by what they did, there was Hashem made that everybody in the children of Israel will know that the prophecies and every word that Moshe Rabbeinu is telling the children of Israel is from the mouth of Hashem. ממה שנעשה אופן העונש והמיטה למרגלים שהוא הפך בשינוי הטבע. Because of this, the spies died and not in a natural way. Immediately they died after Hashem said that one day, 40 days, they went to the land of Israel in order to see what's going on in the land of Israel. He says every day will be for 1 year. That's why the children of Israel were 40 years in the desert. And they died by a plague, not in a natural cause. And the same thing happened to Korach. They didn't die, Korach and all of the people that joined him, they didn't die in a natural cause. But the earth opened its mouth and fire came from heaven, fire came from beneath. And they all, in order that the children of Israel will see that Moshe Rabbeinu speaks the word of Hashem. So how can this happen? And what is the purpose of the Torah and why it is so severe? So not only they slandered the land of Israel, but they also rebelled against Moshe Rabbeinu, and by rebelling against the leader of the children of Israel, they rebelled against Hashem. And by rebelling against Moshe Rabbeinu and Hashem, they rebelled against the Torah that Moshe gave. Torah ציווה לנו משה ומרשה קהילת יעקב. That Moshe commanded us the Torah by the word of Hashem. Morasha, it's the birthright of Yaakov and his descendants, which is us, the children of Israel. So what did Hashem want? He wanted to do well in this world mainly. And why? Because by following the commandments in which comes from the wisdom of Hashem, ki halacha zeh dvar Hashem, the commandment is the word of Hashem. So by following the commandment and doing everything in the sake of heaven, by this we connect heavens and earth. And this is what Hashem wanted, to connect heaven and earth. How do we know that? We can see it even in Sulam Yaakov. We see, we go to Parashat Vayetze, Yaakov Abenu is going, leaving his father and mother, Yitzchak ve'Rivka, and he's leaving them because Esav wants to kill him after he gets the blessings from Yitzchak. And while he's on his way to his uncle, Laban, and he sleeps, and then he sees a ladder. והנה סולם מוצב ארצה וראשו מגיע השמיימה, and there's a ladder that starts from earth and reaches heaven. What does it mean? It means connection between earth and heaven. This is connecting earth and heaven. And we see this also במעמד הר סיני. And when we receive the Torah, it's written over there, Parashat Yitro, בהר סיני השם כולו מפני אשר ירד עליו השם באש. Because Hashem, which means the mountains had a smoke, and because Hashem was dwelling on the mountain in order to connect heaven and earth. By the Torah, our job is to connect heaven and earth and elevate the physical world to a spiritual place. Which means awakening all of the sparks of holiness that are in this physical world. By following the commandments, I'm going to Kitzur Shulchan Aruch, and the first part over there, chapter 31, it says shekol kavanot ha'adam yu l'shem shamayim, that all of the intentions of a person should be in the sake of heaven. And it says amu rabotenu zichronam livracha, our sages said ezoi parasha ktana shekol gufei torah tluim ba. So what is a short verse? That all of the principles of the Torah are connected to it. We are going to Mishlei. King Solomon writes over there, "Bechol drachecha de'eru." In every way that you do in this world, you should know Hashem. which means in everything that you do, even for your the sake of your body, which means you eat, you have weights, everything that you do, you drink, you say a bracha before, you say a blessing before, you say a blessing after, everything that you do, you go to sleep, you say Shema Israel, you put your soul in the hands of Hashem, you wake up in the morning, Modeh Ani Lefanecha, everything that we do is in the sake of heaven. Everything that we use in this world, and even when we speak, Bezrat Hashem, Besiyata Dishmaya means God willing in Aramaic, okay? Bezrat Hashem in Hebrew. So we see over here that everything, Baruch Hashem, that blessed is Hashem, Toda Hashem, thank you Hashem, Ein od milvoder, there's none other Hashem, Bezrat Hashem. So this is what we do, this is what Hashem wanted. How all of this happened, so I would like to go, so this wouldn't have happened to the spies, because it's the evil inclination that they were very righteous people. That's what happens when we are not connected to a tzaddik in this world. We are not connected to a true rabbi that follows the way of Hashem truly without any a personal agenda. Not for the sake of his name, but the sake of Hashem. Everything that he does is for the sake of heaven, for the sake of God. So how they could have prevented this by coming to Moshe Rabbeinu and telling him the report to Moshe Rabbeinu. Moshe Rabbeinu he's called, he has the lights of Abba, Nika Mochin de Abba, which means Orot de Mochin de Abba. He has the lights of Abba. So what does it mean, lights of Abba? Because this is part of the Ten Counts of the Kabbalah. So we have father and mother, and this is the three. This is connected to the three counts of the Kabbalah that are the above three counts, the ones of the head, which is a crown, wisdom, and understanding. So wisdom is called Abba, father, and Bina is called understanding, is called Ima. And we know by this, that's why Yaakov is called Yaakov, because the Yud, the Chochmah, the Zohar HaKadosh says that Yud is the wisdom. And Yud is parallel to the Ten Commandments, the Ten Counts of the Kabbalah, the 10 Days of Atonement, everything is ten, the ten speeches that Hashem created the world. So, and we have 10 fingers parallel to this. So we see the Yud of Yaakov is parallel to the Ten Commandments. Because Yaakov is Amud HaTorah, Yaakov is parallel to the Torah, he's Tiferet, he's the beauty, he combines a mercy and the judgment. This is Tiferet that combines both, and this is parallel to the Torah. Lachen Yaakov is Emet. Emet le'Yaakov v'chesed le'Avraham. It's one of the 13 attributes of Hashem that he gave to Micha. So Yaakov is truth. Who is true? The sealing of whom is true? The sealing of Hashem. Bereshit bara Elokim, in the beginning Hashem created. The end letters in Hebrew is truth. So, which means the sealing of Hashem is truth. A person who wants to come closer to Hashem, wants to repent, to do tshuva, the first step that he needs to do is to cling to the truth, to be true with himself and to be true with God. This is the first step. Once we cling to the truth, Hashem opens our vessel to put his eternal light inside us, so he can help us to come to go in his path, because we need help. We can't overcome the evil inclination on our own. He's from prior and we are just flesh and blood. So by clinging to the truth, this is the first step of doing tshuva. If they would have clinged to Moshe Rabbeinu as the leader of the children of Israel, as the king of the Israelites, and from him he has lights of Orot Mochin de Chochmah, if they would have clinged to Moshe Rabbeinu, then Moshe Rabbeinu would have showed them the way in order that they won't fall and sin by the evil inclination. Because what happens when we come to Katnut Mochin, I'm sorry, but I need to translate everything. When we come to a place that that it's like we don't see the truth, and we cling to our character traits that are not good because of the evil inclination, because all of us want to follow the way of God. all humanity. Because the soul comes, the soul knows its source. The root of the soul is from God. So the soul knows its source, but the evil inclination is here in order to test us. That, oh, this is the freedom of choice. If we will walk in the way of God and walk in the way of truth, or we will walk in the way of the evil inclination that tells us, don't listen. You can circle the corners of the table. Don't listen. It's okay. When you're older, you can do it. Meanwhile, enjoy everything that you have here. And nobody knows when they go out of this world. So in order to stay balanced and to go in the right way, we need to have a rabbi in order that he will show us the right way. Moshe Rabbeinu was the Rebbe of all of the children of Israel. He was the connection between Da'at Shel Am Yisrael. From his mouth, from his Torah, which means the Torah that Hashem gave him, all of the children of Israel were drinking. It's like when you put on a wedding, you put up a cup over here, and then there are cups around it, and you pour champagne on the cup. So the champagne goes in the first cup, and then when it overflows, it goes to the other cups. It's the same thing. We are drinking the light of Hashem, and spiritually and physically, we are drinking from the words of the rabbi or rabbitson that we study from. And if this is a rabbi or rabbitson that or talmid chacham or scholar in Torah, that is true, na'ed dorash na'ed mekayem, which means what he lectures, he also does. Then what happens? We feel it, our souls feel it, and when our souls feel it, we come out of the of studying the Torah with a scholar of Torah or the rabbi or rabbitson or rabbanit. We come out of the shiur and then we take it to our heart and we want to become better, deservable of the term human being. We want to come closer to Hashem. We love Hashem more. We love each other more. Because this is it's a circle of energy that we come into. So if this is a circle of energy that truly has the light of God in it, then we feel it. We want to help everyone. We want to do something good. We want to use all of our organs just to do the will of Hashem and follow His commandments and to make His children happy. And we feel the sorrow of each other. And we care about each other. But this is that the source is from where we are drinking it. If we come out of a Torah lesson and we are the same and we don't do anything, it's something is wrong. So if they would have gone to Moshe Rabbeinu and spoke to him, he would have showed them the right way and caused them not to sin. I will go to Rabbi Nachman in Breslev. He says a beautiful thing about Likutei Moharan, Chelek Aleph. It says like this, chapter 4, Siman 8. And I won't go to Masechet Sotah because we don't have enough time, but he refers to Masechet Sotah, page 21, Amud Aleph, and over there there's a mashal about a person who goes in the darkness, and this person that goes in the darkness, he's afraid of all of the thorns that may be in his way because he won't see them, so he can scratch himself, and he's afraid of wild animals, and he's afraid of bandits, evil people that will come maybe rob him or kill him. And then a torch comes on his way, and now he's happy because now he can see there's thorns around the way, but he's still afraid of wild animals and bandits because he can't see them, and they usually come at night and they hide themselves before they attack someone. And then the light of dawn comes, and when there's light in the world, then he knows that they won't do anything, even though today it's all opposite, because good is evil and evil is good, light is darkness, darkness is light, everything is confused. And so, but still he comes to a crossroad, and he needs to know where to go, but when he comes to a crossroad, he sees the names of all of the streets, and now he knows where to go. So this is parallel to Ner Mitzvah v'Torah Or, that a candle is a commandment, and the Torah is the light of the candle. Okay, so the Torah is the light. A candle is something torch is something, a lamp is something that is temporary, because when a wax is inside and the oil inside, it will light. But after that, when the oil is finished, it won't light anymore. So it's temporary. But the light of the Torah is forever. The light of the Torah is forever. Because like Hashem is eternal, then the light of the Torah is eternal. And the goodness of Hashem is eternal. So we are coming to Rabbi Nachman Mibreslav, Alav Hashem Zchutot Tagen Aleinu, what Rabbi Natan wrote in his name, Alehem Hashalom Zchutam Tagen Aleinu. And he says this, maybe we'll have to have another lesson just to explain this, but I'm giving you in order that you will understand what happened here. If they would have attached themselves to the tzaddik of the generation, which is Moshe Rabbeinu, that he has Orot de Mochin de Abba, then they wouldn't fall with such a sin. So we come over here, and he says that all of the sins come from the four, and Neder, maybe next week we'll have a lesson on Monday, Bezrat Hashem, about this, because it's very thorough and it's very important. So there are four fundamental elements that Hashem created this world, the physical world, from. And these four, they are parallel to a greenish liquid that comes from a liver that is called mara. And this is what the liver brings out. And this is called in English, I hope I'm pronouncing it well, it's gall and bile. Okay, there are four galls or biles, any way that you want to call it. And it comes from the four fundamental elements that the world was created with, and that these four can be from the good side and from not the good side, which means there's a fire, water, earth, and air. These are the four. These are parallel to our character traits. We are influenced by this. This is parallel also. How do we know what do we need to fix? So some of it we know by our constellations, because also the constellations are divided to these four elements. Okay, I won't go into it, but I'll go to the result. Lineda on Monday will study this more thoroughly, also by Rabbi Chaim Vital, Shari Kedusha, Bezrat Hashem. But because we don't have time now, but we'll go to what do we mean when you have to be connected to a tzaddik and ask. It's better to ask, you know, for advice than to do what the evil inclination tells you. The first thought that a person has, it's from Hashem. All of the other politics that come after that is the evil inclination that doesn't want you to listen to Hashem. For example, if we have, you know, we thought to give tzedakah, immediately Hashem gives us the amount in our heads. But then the evil inclination says, oh, but you know, you shouldn't give this person this amount of tzedakah. You can divide it, you can do this, you can do this. But Hashem gives us exactly. The first thought is from, it's clean, pure from Hashem. Then all of the other thoughts is the evil inclination that comes in. And these are also immediately personal touches, personal agendas that come in. So he says like this, ויש שלוש בחינות בהתקרבות לצדיקים. There are three aspects of coming closer to the righteous in the generation. And each righteous of the generation is considered Moshe Rabbeinu. He's considered Moshe Rabbeinu. I wrote it from the Zohar Kadosh. That's a good question. Where did I write it? But it's each one is from each righteous person is considered Moshe Rabbeinu. Okay, I don't see it right now, but Bezrat Hashem, next time. because the Zohar Kadosh ממש writes it. Oh. It's written like this, Parashat Bereshit in the Zohar Kadosh, page 25 Amud Bet, or 27 Amud Aleph. It's written like this, Ad ki yavo Shilo, this is what Yaakov Avinu gave a blessing to Yehuda, to his son Judea, and he gave him and he gave him the blessing, Parashat Beyechid, the end of Chumash Bereshit, Ad ki yavo Shilo, until Shilo will come. On this says the Zohar Kadosh, Da Moshe Mashiach. He says, know that this is Moshe Mashiach, and it says that every tzaddik, kol tzaddik shebador, every tzaddik, every righteous person, truly righteous person in the generation, is considered like Moshe Mashiach. Moshe Rabbeinu Mashiach. So, but b'siyata dishmaya, let's continue. What is it? He says three things. In order to come closer, and in order that we won't, that we will stay in the right path, because we need advice. We are just human beings, and we get advice from the good inclination and from the evil inclination, and sometimes we get confused because we have a personal agenda. That's why we get confused. הבחינה הראשונה, כשרואה את הצדיק, when you see, when you go to the rabbi, and you see, visualize him, you see him. Personally, you see him. כשרואה את הצדיק, שכתוב, it says in Isaiah chapter 30, והיו עיניך רואות את מוריך. That your eyes should see your teachers, your rabbis, your רבניות, whatever. בעזרת השם, you should see the righteous person that is guiding you. And know that it's also a סגולה not to forget all what you study. To remember your studies, is to visualize the rabbi that teaches you. And this by seeing the tzaddik, this eliminates part of the character traits that are not good. Mevatelet amidot ra'ot. And I won't go into it because we'll do it on Monday bli neder. So this is one thing. The b'china shniya, הצדקה שנותן את תלמיד חכם. The tzedakah, the charity that you give to the rabbi and to the scholars of Torah. Why? Because this also takes away the evil, the character traits that are not good. And not only that, when we give a tzedakah to a righteous person, what happens is, if we had a decree that is not good, then this decree with the tzedakah is taken away. Why? Because if we had a decree, and decrees like mavet, like death in Hebrew, mavet, mem, vav, taf, and it's like death if a person is sick, if he has a trial, any decree that is not good. By giving charity to a scholar in Torah, to a rabbi, to a yeshiva, to a kollel, by giving the charity, then the rabbi that is davening for us, that is praying, the chacham, the mori, that is praying for us, he, by his prayers, can turn this mavet, this death, into ma'ot. Ma'ot in Aramaic is money. But by putting the ayin inside, and why the ayin? Ki katuv ki tov ayin yevorach, which means King Solomon says that a person with a good eye, that has a good heart, with a good eye, will be blessed. So that our sages say, don't say Yevorach, don't read it Yevorach, read it Yevarech, that he will bless, because a person that has a good eye, then all of his essence is to give blessings with all of his heart. And when you give blessings with all of your heart, Hashem listens to these blessings and does them. So he turns the mavet to ma'ot. Ma'ot is money in kesef in Hebrew. Ma'ot is money in Aramaic. So this is the second thing. הצדקה שנותן תלמיד חכם. והבחינה השלישית כשמתוודא בידוי דברים לפני תלמיד חכם. שעל ידי זה התלמיד חכם מדריך אותו בדרך ישרה לפי שורש נשמתו. The third thing, so the first thing is to see the righteous person, because once you see him, because the Shekhinah is above him, the divine presence is above the righteous, and when you see him, it also this circle of energy also comes to you, so you get out of the confusion because you see him. Second, to give tzedakah. Tzedakah tatzil mimavet. Tzedakah saves from death, which means all of the harsh decrees. The third thing is to speak, שמתבדה בידוי דברים לפני תלמיד חכם, that he comes to the righteous person and he tells him his sorrow. And when he tells him his sorrow, שעל ידי זה, he confesses about things that bother him and things that he goes through, then he gives the Talmid Chacham, the scholar in Torah, gives him an advice to connect him to the root of his soul, to connect him to God. But by his root, where he is connected, and by this, he eliminates the evil inclination from the person that came to him. He opens the path for him to go and walk in the way of Hashem because by the advice that he gives him. And who gives the advice to the scholar in Torah? Hashem. Yosef HaTzadik, when Paro tells him that he wants him to solve the dream, he says, God is going to solve your dream. I'll tell you what God tells me. What he puts in my mouth. בשם השם נעשה ונצליח אין על מדוע, השם שפתי תפתח ופי יגיתי לתך. In the name we will do and succeed, השם open my mouth and I will say your praise. So if the spies would have went to Moshe Rabbeinu and given the report to Moshe Rabbeinu, Moshe Rabbeinu would have helped them not to fall in such a sin, rebelling against slandering the land of Israel and by this rebelling against God and Moshe Rabbeinu. The same thing was with Korach. So from here we learn that in order to come closer, why do we come closer to the righteous? In order that we will, in this world which is temporary world, we just came to do the fixing. Isn't that a shame? That we won't do the goal that we came for in this world, the fixing. So how do we do that? By coming closer to the righteous. How do we come closer to the righteous? We come closer by seeing the tzaddik, by coming and meeting him. The second thing, by giving tzedakah. The third thing is by confessing and telling everything that bothers us in order to that he will show us b'siyata d'shmaya, with the help of Hashem, he will show us the right way that we won't fall. And by this, the Shekhinah, the Divine Presence, is also all over us. Hashem helps us. And with this, I would like to bless all of us, that we will all have the zechut to greet Mashiach Tzidkan Barachamim Boim Bimra Bimeinu Amen. Eliyahu Nabi Zechul Atov, L'olam Yipred Adam Mechavor, B'Dbar Halacha Yachim Berabim, Halacha Kerabim. אחינו כל בית ישראל הנתונים בצרה ובשביעה, העומדים בין בים ובין ביבשה, המקום ירחם עליהם, ויוציא מצרה לרווחה, ומאפלה לאורה, משבוד לגאולה, השתה, דאג לה, בזמן קריב, ימרו, אמן.
אמן.